Hello traders, welcome to KinFX Academy YouTube channel. My name is Akin Lakin. So I welcome you to this video. So in this strategy, guys, I'm going to show you the simple way you can use to scalp boom and crash, and at the same time the strategy that allow you to cash spike and trade in normal market direction. You understand? So guys, this is the simple strategy you are seeing on my chart. It contains RSI and moving averages. So I'm going to delete everything on my chart. I'm going to add it together. I'm going to tell you the conditions you need to follow before using this strategy. The good things about this strategy is that it's good for all the boom and crash markets, 1000 to 300. So guys, let me delete everything on my chart so that we can follow the step by adding it back. So on the main chart now, we are going to add the moving average, which is 15 period moving average exponential. So you come to the F plus, you find the moving average, you change the period here to 15. Leave it shift zero, method exponential, apply to close. So under the star here, so you can choose different color of your choice. I like using blue, so click on done. If you do it correctly, you should have something like this on your chart. You understand? Let's make it thicker. You understand? It's a main chart. Let's use 4 pixels. You can see it here, so you can do that on your chart too. So what does this moving average works for? This moving average tells us when the market is buying and when the market is selling. So how do we know when the market is buying? We know when this moving average is below the candles. That is where we know the market is buying. And how do you know the market is selling? We know when the moving average is above the candles. That is what the work of this particular moving average we just added is, tell us the market trend. Then how do we use it, and how do we use it to trade? That is where we need this RSI in the indicator window. So come to the tools here, come to your indicators and find relative strength index, which is this. Leave the settings like this, period one. You can any period, because we don't actually really need it. So that is where you will come this under this style. Choose the color, the background of your chart. If you are using dark background, you have to choose black. If you are using white like mine, choose white here. So what else? Come to the level. Under the level, we need to use level 19 and level 10. So after we have done that, then go back. You understand? Click on done. If you do that correctly, you should be able to see this on your chart. You understand? It has to be plain. It contains nothing at this stage. You understand? If you do it correctly, so you know, we all know how the RSI works. We have the level 90. The level 90 tells us when the market is overbought, and when the level 10 tells us when the market is oversold. That is, when you see markets come to this level, it tells us that the buyers are taking their profits. It's possible for a reversal to happen. Same thing when the markets come to this region, it tells us the sellers are taking their profit. Reversal is about to take on. So how do we still use this strategy? We still need more tools. You understand? What else do we need? We need an indicator, moving average indicator. Come to the indicator window one, click on F plus, then find the moving average. This time around, we are changing the period to 50. This 15, change it to 50 now. The shift is zero, method exponential. You know, we have to change the color so that it won't get us distracted with the main on the one on the main chart. So I want to use red. Yeah, you can use any color of your choice. I don't know whether that is red, but at least it's yes, I think I get that now. That is red. Then click on done. You should get it now. Fine. This is the slow moving average. Here it stands. It gives us a long time information about the market. Now it tells us that the market is buying in this place, and when it gets to the offer bought region, then it started selling. You understand? When it gets to the oversold region again, it started buying. So how do we still use this? We still need one more indicators. You understand? So we have to go back there and add the last indicators on this strategy. So click on the moving average again. So this time we are using one as our first EME. You understand? So we are using one as our first EME. So the shift is zero, method exponential. So stars still remain 4 pixels, but we are changing the color. I like using green for fast EME. So what does the fast EME mean? Fast EME tells us immediate situation in the market. You understand what is happening instantly in the market. You understand? So and you know what is happening Now and what has been happening before align. That is a good signal for us to trade. You understand? So how do we trade this particular strategy? When the markets, both when the fast and the slow EMA touches the overbought, you understand, you should be ready to sell. And you know, when we are selling on crash, that means we are catching spike, right? So once you see the fast EMA crossing the slow EMA at the overbought region, you know, sell as activate. Once you see this crossing, sell as activate, but you don't sell immediately. You still have to wait for a confirmation. So don't rush. Watch this video to the end so that you won't miss out any information. You understand? So what are the information you need to watch out for? You understand? So if you know about that, about price action very well, you understand? So once this crossing happens, when you look at the chart, you will see something like a reversal pattern forming on the chart. You can see there's a double top here. You understand? You can see those rejection at that level. You understand? So there are rejection at this level. You understand? So how do we enter? Yeah, if you don't know anything about price action, just don't worry. So I'm just using that as a reference. You understand? So once you have seen this crossing happening here, then you wait for candle. You know, I've already explained earlier that once the moving average is above the candle, it tells us uptrend, and when it's below the it tells us downtrend, and when it is below the candle, it tells us uptrend. So now it's above the candle. So you know, this crossing happened here. It happens here. You have to see the crossing happening clearly. You understand? So before decide to put a trade. So once you see this crossing happen when the candle is here, so you patiently be waiting for an early candle to close below the moving average. Early candle means like there will be much body inside the moving average. You understand? So now we can see an early candle here that close below the moving average. Understand? Don't let me use the word edit to confuse you. Like anytime the candle close below the moving average, you see that's a good signal. Your stop loss is going to be the immediate structure after that candle, like before that candle, sorry, the immediate structure before that candle, which is here. Your stop loss is going to be here. Then when do you take profit? You can take profit at next structure, or you wait to the market. You can take your profit here. You can decide to take it here, or when this fast EMA, which is the green, touches the 10, you can decide to take your profit. You understand? So that is how that these strategies work. So, and then when you are buying, you can see the market has come to the oversold region. Understand? So, and the crosses has happened, as we explained. So you patiently wait for this candle to cross the moving average. Understand? Your stop loss is here. You understand? With this strategy, if you get one or two signals, let me say one signal in a day, you understand, you will be in money. One thing about this signal is also help to kill emotion in the market. You know, when you are trading, when you are scalping 5 candle, 2 candle, your mind, your emotion is going to be controlling you. You understand? But when you are trading a very long time on the market, you will have more confidence about the market. You understand? So it will kill your emotion fast. You understand? So that is all about this strategy. You can do your back test. I've tried it. The strategy is okay. You are using 15 minutes time frame and the second zoom level. You understand? So you are using 15 minutes time frame and the second zoom level. You understand? You can also use the strategy on a 1 minute time frame, but I prefer using it on 15 minutes time frame because I want to stay long in the market. I want to make enough profit in the market. The strategy is good for all the markets, like I said earlier. So guys, go to your demo account, do some back test, then put on trade before you decide to trade it on a live account. I wish you happy trading. Share this video. Don't forget to subscribe to this channel so that if you want to continue seeing good strategy like this, you understand. So I wish you happy trading. Always trade responsibly.